What is up, my dudes? Offbeat Gaming is back in Shimmeryard Tensei 3 Nocturne. It all comes down to this. The big finale. Here we go. The question is, can I maintain my composure? Nether? It's probably Nether, Earth, Heaven, right? Yeah, it seems to be right. Because that's like the order in which I got them. Or maybe it doesn't actually matter. Maybe you just put all three in the pillars. My largest concern, absolutely largest concern, is RNG. Deciding whether or not to fuck me over, because really that's kind of what a lot of these final battles are gonna
do. You have proven yourself worthy. Come to me.
Alright, here we go. Go to Kagutsuchi. None of them really did that work that hard to win me over. In fact, most of them attacked me anytime I saw them.
And the possibility of a new world has been crushed forever.
Yep.
By the hand of a deity. Persuaded by the fallen angel, you destroyed the seeds of creation, denying the reincarnation of the world. With the cold heart of a demon, you rejected the possibility of evolution. By casting aside your humanity, you became the living incarnation of ruin itself. Begone, accursed one! I shall never forgive you for causing the death of the world. My light, searing with anger, shall wipe you from existence!
Alright, now this guy has two boss fights. Well, two phases. First phase, he has 20,000 HP. Second phase, he has 40,000. His defense levels are dependent entirely on the moon phase, which is going to progress up and down in terms of two every turn. And then he has one super ability that he can only use on the full moon. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna give me a chance to hit him while it's currently new moon and its defense is the lowest. Booyah. I think on new moon his defense is minus 200%. At 4, he's 100. At 6, he's... No, I think I'm jumping percentages too quick on that. But he's definitely the weakest at noon, and right now he's still not exactly super strong. so we're still going to pass to give myself another chance to shoot him. Because the sooner we can get through this phase and into the next one, the better. Cool. So just like that, he's already over half dead. Yeah, so now he is at 100% defense. So this is where attacks kind of do regular damage to him. But he's also at like freaking... He's already taken over 13,000 damage, so he's already almost dead in this phase. That should have been 20,000. This game lied to me. Well, he's shaking, so I think he's almost dead. Yeah. Or maybe he would have just transformed when it was his next turn. In any case, now he's got phase 2, 40,000 HP. The moon is always full, so he can always do his super attack whenever he wants. And it does buku dick ton damage. Takes him two turns to use it. So it takes two of his little turn markers up there to use his super attack. As possible.
I am destined.
I can only assume that means maybe next turn he'll do it. So I want to keep my dudes all fully healed. Because it gonna hurt. Sick, I'll use this extra turn to restore his MP. Got chakra pots just for this occasion. Yeah, so that's it. Infinite light. Yeah. It's an almighty attack that does, I think, percentage-based damage. But the percentage isn't... It's not dependent on how much health we have when it hits us, it's dependent on what our actual max health is, so no matter how much health you have, it's always going to do a dick ton of damage and basically almost kill you outright. But if you aren't at full health when it hits, it will literally destroy you. I believe he's now over half dead.
I am the truth.
I've just got him so damaged that he's just gonna keep forcing it through. Eh, fuck it, I'll focus punch. Still hurt like a bitch. I'm pretty sure it's probably like a damage threshold thing, like he does it after he's taken so much damage, and I just kinda keep forcing him through. Falling apart. Where are those crits when you need them, huh? Finish him. Go for it. All or nothing. Booyah! Perfect time for a critical. Alright, that's over. What? Why am I not celebrating? You'll see.
What good can come of being tainted with iniquity? Be forewarned, demon who was once human. Though I may perish, your soul will never again be at ease. The final hour is imminent. Those who dwell in darkness shall suffer the light of judgment. After the battle to end all battles is won, you will be cast into the fire. Let fear grip your heart. Because of your transgressions, you will be cursed for all eternity.
Good, man. Feels good, but also horrible at the same time. Because with that accomplished, the entire Vortex world is now fucked. Thus creating an infinite void, just as Lord Lucifer wanted. Now there is but one more battle. For you see, I've done as asked, but before I could truly be the leader of his army,
so,
the general of chaos
he desires,
Lucifer himself,
by the hand of a demon, no less,
has a trial for me, and that trial...
Now the world will never be born again. Creation is no longer possible.
...is coming. And this trial is why the true demon end is the hardest.
Maturation, death, and being born anew. That was once the way of the world.
Notice the kid's shadow.
Yet one demon has changed that.
Created, populated by mankind, and destroyed. This cycle is what maintains the flow of time. When the cycle stops, so does time itself. And now, time has met her death. In place of the creation of the new world, a new power of darkness emerged, raining chaos, heaping death upon death. You must abandon all preconceived notions and walk the path of supreme power with your head held high. The great will shall surely curse you for going against his way. He will place a heavy burden of atonement on your shoulders, which you shall bear for all eternity. But fear not, for only by receiving that curse can you truly walk the path of conquest. First, I must know the extent of the power of darkness you hold within.
Don't do it, please.
Behold, the supreme power of darkness, created by none other than the Great Will himself.
Because the old man and the child are one and the same, two halves of a whole. And when combined, he takes on his true form. And if you thought anything I fought in the past was big, if you thought anything that I have faced up until this point was massive, meet Lucifer. Oh god. Oh fuck, we're here. Oh fuck, we're here. Fuck. I've done this once before, but now that I'm actually looking at you face to face, I don't want to be here. He has 65,535 HP, by the way. This dude is an absolute unit. But that's not even the worst of it. The worst of it is yet to come in the form of two skills. Root of Evil is one in particular that I don't want to have to deal with, but I know it's coming. And High King is the name of the other, both of which are going to suck. Oh, and his regular attack is almighty damage, by the way, so there's nothing that can make you immune to it. RNG, don't do this. RNG, don't do this. Please. I'm just a little boy. Dodged. Cool. This part in particular, I didn't. Kagetsuchi wasn't even on the radar, I'll be honest. Kagetsuchi was not even thought about. This guy right here, this is the final boss when we're talking of true demon ending. High King! Ooh, Papa no! And that's not even his worst skill. Time for that. We are not ready for the next attack to follow. He is going to murder someone. Not me, not me, not me. Oh god. Not me, not me, not me. Oh, fuck me. Lucifer, ladies and gentlemen. Lucifer, ladies and gentlemen. want it to end this way. But I've come this far. I'm sorry, little one. And that is why it's all RNG. No, fuck this. No, it's gotta be on hard mode. Fuck this. It's gotta be. I've come too far.
Fool.
Come on. Shut up. Fight me. Fight me! Fight me!
Fight me harder. Get out of my sight! Come on. Can't have much left. Come on. Fucking leave. Fucking get out of here! RNG, do not dick me.
By the now create birth match death and that yet.
Yep. Faster, please. Fight me!
Oh, and this and in place and
I love this. This must fan art, just tiny little Naoki just staring at Lucifer. Fight me!
But
I feel like that'd be hilarious.
Alone for behold.
Yeah. This is part of the problem. I realize I don't have any self buffs. Because of that, he's always gonna hurt. souks, man. I miss my souks. I don't know why I created demons with no buffs, now that I think about it. Like, what the fuck? What the hell's wrong with me? I'm all offense. I'm all offense and no defense. I do appreciate that in Evil Gleam. Dick. I do appreciate that in 4 and hopefully 5 as well when that comes out, there actually is a buff that is the counter to Debilitate, where Debilitate lowers all stats, the buff actually raises all the stats. I feel like that'd be a very nice thing to have. So I could have one person that literally has a debuff all, and another person has a buff all, and I think that would be a great fucking balance. Fight me! Last time he did that, it was followed immediately by High King, and I was very ready for everything to go to shit. That's alright. Start over. Let's stay topped off in case of bullshit. Here comes the bullshit. Twice? You're twicing me? You're a dick. You're a monster. Already in effect. Seriously! Having to keep healing from that is really messing with my jam. Just gonna throw that out there, like, I really am not appreciating all this hate that I'm feeling. Ugh! RNG, please stop! Why? Not me. Why me? No! It's like the game knows. Came so far, I fought so hard, but in the end, it just wasn't worth it. I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't fucking do it. do it simply for the fact that I don't have any buffs and I don't want to take the time to go make. If I leave the tower, I have to climb the fucking tower again, and I don't want to put myself through that. We're already at 34 minutes for this video, I think. Skipping all the dialogue, I might have time for one more try, so we're just gonna do this on easy. I just wanna get the end. I just wanna finish it now. Skipping the dialogue, I feel like the Kagetsuchi should die a little faster too. See, the problem with Lucifer is he's hard no matter what difficulty you're on, except for Merciful. Just because it's so. Here's the thing. He hasn't even used Root of Evil yet, but High King does dick tons of damage, as you've seen, and has a 100% chance to, or near 100% chance to bind. And then when he uses Root of Evil is literally a dice roll of how much it wants to fuck you. Okay, it is a chance of doing 10%. 30%, 60%, or 90% damage. So, literally, if he uses Root of Evil, it's just, hey, do you die this time? Look at that, you live! Yes. We've been here. Guess what? We've been here. I don't give a fuck what you have to say, because I am here to end your life again. Really should have gave all three of these guys debilitate. Carries over between forms, so I'm pretty sure he's still fully debuffed. But we'll try again next turn just in case. Limit reached. Realize I probably don't even need to be fully healed for this anymore. Man, that hurts so much less. It's like, now... this... it doesn't feel right, you know? The saddest part is if I had played this game on any difficulty other than True Demon, I would have finished it on hard. But because it's True Demon and I have to fight Lucifer to finish the story, I can't beat it on hard. Not when RNG decides to fuck me.
So, but now create birth, match, death, and be that. Yet.
And this and that. In a new. And what? The evil. But. For all. For. We hope.
Again. At least the game is nice enough to fully restore your shit before this fight. which I will not. I won't even sugarcoat it. If I can't beat this guy on normal, I will literally swap this to merciful just to finish this story. Seeing a lot fewer High Kings. What's your fascination with hitting the same guy every time? You know what, this is a great side-by-side. We'll use this as a learning experience. This is the game side-by-side, normal versus hard mode. To give you an idea of just how much this game was fucking me. Now it's like he's really not even trying in comparison, isn't it? It's... seeing firsthand what he did to me in the previous attempts versus this. Can you even believe I'm playing the same game? See that? He didn't even become the poor High King, so he hit me with his debuffed strength. There's Root of Evil. apparently all dodge. By the way, yeah, he has a skill to heal, and that's the first time he's ever even used it. Lucifer's dead. I win. Hall of victory.
Well done. You've proven yourself with your awesome power.
All you who have lurked in darkness and waited for this day, hear me. A new demon of darkness has been born. The time has come. Together, let us march onward. To the final battle, where our true enemy awaits!
And that's the true demon ending. I am the general of the Army of Chaos. I'm sorry I had to turn it down. You're creating a demon in your heart's likeness, fallen angel? Then doom shall set us apart. Now and forevermore. I'm sorry I had to turn the difficulty down just to win. I didn't want to do that, but as I said, you saw night and day the difficulty a level alone. I couldn't do it on hard mode, I accept that, but at the very least, I got the ending I wanted. And this is still one of my favorite, probably my favorite game of all time. And I am beyond stoked for the fifth installment coming in November. I will do my damnedest to get something set up to actually record it, because unfortunately it is a Switch exclusive. If I can't record it, then sorry. I'm going to play it regardless, so either at the time I get it, I can record it, or at the time I get it, I can't. But in either case, I'm going to play it. It's gonna happen. I can't not play it. And there's a chance that it might literally absorb my entire being for a while. So, you know, I'm looking forward to it. More so than I can express. There's a sort of divisiveness in the West when it comes to the Shin Megami Tensei games, because obviously there's the Persona series, and then there's the mainline series, and then the other spin-offs that also are in relation to Devil Summoners, one literally called Devil Summoner. Persona, I personally find kind of boring, but at the same time I'm grateful of Persona, because Persona is the reason that these games gained enough traction to exist in America. With, I think, Persona 3. Persona 3, like, basically imported the game series itself. And I don't know, I've just never really much been a fan I never much really cared for the whole premise of trying to maintain the character's school lives while simultaneously doing the dungeon crawl. I like just the dungeon crawling. I like the RPG. I like the RPG of it. But that's just me, I guess. I mean, I'm not going to say that anyone who likes the Persona games is wrong. I just feel like my personal opinion is whatever game was your overall first exposure to the series is probably going to be what you prefer. My first experience with the game series was Nocturne, and as such, I probably will always have a preference to the mainline entries, but to those who found themselves exposed via Persona, they prefer Persona, that's fine, they have that right. I'm just glad that Shin Megami Tensei exists here in the West, where we all can enjoy it. Be it one way or the other, it is by far one of the best series that I have ever tried in my life. And this may well, opinion of five pending, this may still to this day remain my favorite game of all time. Something about it is, I love the story, I love the multiple choices for the ending, I love that if you try to basically do as you're told and get to the bottom of the labyrinth, you're more or less punished by the very person who told you to do it, who will then fuck you right up. But ultimately, I feel that this game in particular, the risk versus reward has always just kind of been more my bread and butter, I guess. To where, if you play right, the game will absolutely just lay itself out for you, but if you make mistakes, thinking that it'll just be any RPG from Japan, it'll fuck you right up. And Matador's kind of a gatekeeper for that kind of playstyle. To where most people, when they get to Matador, have fond memories of Matador, they know of him, everybody knows it. He's kind of the one that turns people away if you don't know how to stop him, because he gains traction so fast and just fucks everything up. And people know this. Anyone who's played this game knows Matador. And they know to fear him. But ultimately, Localization Development, ITL Incorporated, thank you very much for localizing. I think the video is actually almost out of time anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up here. This has been my playthrough of Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne. I am so sorry I didn't finish it on hard. I do have one more filler episode set aside for Puzzle Boy, which I will set up as a bonus after this one goes up, just because it's something I have sitting in. For all intents and purposes, obviously I had all the Magatama, so obviously I finished the Puzzle Boy game. Actually, looks like I had just enough time for all the credits, huh? That's pretty awesome. Alright, so thank you all much for watching.